So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming and interest on your this topic, the geoanalysis and all the papers on academic track. So we have three presentations in this session. The first one will be given by Sylvia Francescini, and also we have many co-authors here. So the first presentation is introducing the OSGeo UN Committee Educational Challenges. That is one of the activities supporting UN Open GIS initiative activity on behalf of OSGeo. So please welcome Sylvia with big hands.
Thank you.
So 20-minute presentation. 5-minute Q&A,
yep.
5-minute
retraining the speakers. Okay, let me know if I'm late. Okay. So thank you for coming. Good afternoon. And so my presentation will be about my experience in the OSGeo UN Educational Challenge of 2018. So first of all, let me try to introduce myself. I'm an environmental engineer specialized in hydrology and hydraulic and forestry. I have a PhD in mountain environmental and agriculture and developed scientific model for in the field of hydrology, hydraulic and forestry. I'm also a co-founder of the of a very small engineering company, which is called Hydrologies. We are placed in based in Italian. I am in Italy, and I am also an OSGeo charter member. And last year, in 2018, I won the OSGeo UN Challenge Spiral 3. So during this presentation, I will introduce you the OSGeo UN committee, and then in particular, the challenge of 2018. And then we will go a bit in deep with the description of the aims and the results of the challenge number 1 and 3. And then we will see some future step and some results of my experience. So the OSGeo UN committee promotes the development and use of open source software that meets UN needs and support the aims of UN. And one particular project, the most important project of this committee, is the UN Open GIS initiative, which is a project to identify and develop an open source GIS bundle that meets the requirements of UN operators, taking full advantages of the experience of mission partners, including partner nations, technology contributing countries and international organizations, academia, NGO, and private sectors. If you want to know some more details about this program and the OSGeo committee in particular, you can go to the OSGeo wiki page dedicated especially to this committee. The project UN Open GIS Initiative in particular is organized into working groups, and these working groups are called spirals. And there are four spirals. Spiral 1 focuses on a new open source web platform for data collection. Spiral 2 focuses on capacity building. Spiral 3 is related to new functionalities needed by the UN staff for field operations. And Spiral 4 focuses on data in general, from the collection to the assessment and integration in the systems. In 2018, it has been launched the first OSGeo UN Educational Challenge. It aimed at addressing the lack of training material for using the open source dataset and open source software in supporting the UN Sustainable Development Goals. There were three challenges in particular. The first challenge was related to Spiral 1, and it was dedicated to the development of documentation for the GeoShAPE platform for data collection. Challenge number 2, related to Spiral number 3, covers some functionality for UN operators. And challenge number 3, was related to open geospatial data and software for the UN Sustainable Development Goals. The winners of these challenges were guided by mentors of the UN OSGeo UN Committee in developing the material. The criteria for the evaluation of the candidates were the membership of OSGeo, so if the participant was an OSGeo charter member, the documented experience in education and training, the age, younger participants were favorite respect to older, and the experience respect to what it was proposed in the particular specific challenge. So this was in general about the challenges. And now we go a bit in deep with challenge number one and challenge number three. Challenge number one, was strictly related to spiral number one, and in particular, it was dedicated to the development of documentation for GeoShAPE. GeoShAPE is a platform designed to enable collaboration on geospatial information between mission partners in connected and unconnected environments. The main objectives of GeoShAPE are to create, edit, and share critical data in integrated environment and dynamic map and share dynamic map in real time, to view map updates by the user from anywhere in the world, and to work in connected and disconnected environments. This is an example of the training material. The training material has been developed and published in the wiki page, and the course is structured with the content to suit all the levels of users, from novice, intermediate, and advanced users. Regarding challenge number three, this was related to spiral number three, which is the spiral which involves experts from different institutions in a collaborative way and using a common platform, open source platform. The aim is to develop a spatial analysis function to support the United Nations peacekeeping operations, in particular to collect the requests from the UN operators and develop spatial analysis in two kind of systems, as primitive spatial analysis algorithm, and then integrating these algorithms in a spatial analysis model as an integrated environment, working online and offline. And then, the least but not last, object is to develop the training material for this open source spatial analysis function, and then to train UN operators on these tools. The developed training material is a full documentation available online on the wiki page of OSGeo and also as a PDF to download. And it is based on a data set containing free open data, which are data from satellite images, digital terrain model, and vector layers. The area covered, as an example, is an area near around Seoul in South Korea. And the training material has been developed with the purpose to introduce a user to the algorithm contained in this processing toolbox, particularly focusing on environmental analysis related to ecology and ecosystems identification. The tutorial contains the description of the tools, the usage of the tools, and a set of tools in a path to analyze rasters and vector data with the processing toolbox. And the material is complete. You can see, you can follow it step by step, considering there is the description of the module, the scientific meaning of the module, and then the graphical interface, and a description of the input and output, and some images of the output. So you can really follow it and check if your results are the same as those expected by the tutorial. This is an example of the training material. This is the full training material. And then, for example, I wrote the documentation to cover some preliminary operation to harmonize the data, because all over the world you can have data from different sources and of different coordinate reference systems. So it covers operation like reprojection and clipping. And regarding the imagery analysis, in particular, we analyzed Landsat 8 images, and there are operations to do some statistics on this data, the elaboration of the NDVI index, the reclassification of the data, and the possibility to merge the different bands of a same satellite. Regarding the digital terrain model analysis, it covers some statistics, zonal statistics, spatial relationship, to understand which is the content of the data, and then some morphological analysis, very easy morphological analysis, like slope, curvature, roughness, and until the elaboration of the terrain roughness index. And it is possible, there are also operations that relate point vector layers and raster layers, like assigning some specific values to of a raster layer to a vector layer. But regarding only the vector data, there are interesting statistics like point pattern analysis, the nearest neighbor index, the kernel density, and then the nearest neighbor distance, and there is also the possibility in this tutorial and in the tools to export nice charts like histogram and scatter plot. So this is almost everything. A very short description of what we did in 2018. Future steps regarding the OSGeo committee the first one is the launching of the challenge 2019, and this year there were two challenges. The first one dedicated to the update of post-GIS training material, and the second one dedicated to, in general, open geospatial data and software for reaching the UN Sustainable Development Goals in peace, justice, and open institutions. They have been assigned, and they are working on this on the documentation. In particular, future step for spiral number 3 is the development of user-friendly web interfaces for the platform, from the common platform, including the outcomes of other spirals. And then the development of new training material, and maybe starting to train the UN operators using this training material and the new one that will be developed. So I think we can do some conclusion of my personal experience, my personal and the experience of the other winners of the challenge and also of the mentors, is that it is possible to work. Different experts can work from different parts of the world and collaborate for the same project, even if there are no personal meetings, working only online. And then we realized that good material, training material, has to be written by persons that are experts in in both the science and the use of the softwares. Otherwise, the training material will miss some steps, and for the user is a bit harder to follow it and understand what it means. And then also the conclusion. One conclusion is that to have a good documentation, it is better to develop a quick start tutorial and not full manuals, because a user will lost in a full manual instead of following step by step a quick tutorial. And in general, in any case, the challenge in 2018 contributed successfully to the OSGeo UN committee's aim, which is to promote and develop the use of open source software, meeting the UN needs and supporting the aims of the UN. So, thank you.
Her presentation very on time, just 20 minutes exactly.
It's fine.
Okay, so no questions. No questions?
No questions.
Okay, I have then one question. So, since you know, this challenge started last year, what kind of the plan for continuing this activity, you know, so this year, next year?
My personal?
Personal, and also on behalf of the OSGeo committee, you know, is there any plan?
Okay, this year the OSGeo committee launched the new challenge of 2019, which has been assigned. I personally tried to participate, but I didn't win this year. So I'm trying to go on. In any case, what I do, my activity of writing documentation is still available, and I continue with this activity with other softwares, hoping that some of this software meets also the UN requests.
Thank you. So still, I don't see none. So our next presentation will be started. It's 2:30. So 3 o'clock we will start. Thank you.